Praise God, praise God. This is Apostle Deanna Dixon. So, I pray that you all are having a blessed afternoon in the name of Jesus. Wherever you are in the world, it could be morning, noon, or night. God bless you and God keep you. I'm also saying hello to my YouTube family, Tumblr family, all outlets, social media outlets. Praise God. So something has been pressing on me and I really wanted to be prayerful about it. And so I finally got an answer from God. I want to offer a spiritual wholeness class. It's going to be on Sundays at 3 p.m. I have never taught on a Sunday. So, you know, I know it's God. Point blank in the store, because there's so many people hurting, God says. There's so many people going through. I don't care how much you love God. I love God. We all go through. Come on, somebody. And so a lot of you have asked me to counsel you. There's no way I can counsel all the people that ask me, especially one-on-one. There's just no way. However, what I do want to do is get in a classroom atmosphere. We do questions and answers. We're going to hit every point. Come on, somebody. Let me go ahead and walk this thing through. Number one, I want y'all to know it's okay to cry it out. It's okay. The world tried to teach us that, okay, if you cry or if you go through something, that means you're weak. That doesn't mean you're weak. You're human. You're human. And I don't care how strong you are, we all got some stuff. We all got some problems. Well, come on, somebody. Hallelujah. Number two, I want you to know you got to let it process before jumping into a solution. Most people, when something happens, you panic, you run to people. You got to calm that down. You got to just get in the place, cry it out, walk it out, and be like, God, what do I do next? I think sometimes we move too fast. Truth be told, most of the problems, sometimes we cause them. We don't want to really say that. We'll try to blame a person, a place, a thing, or even a job. And I'm not saying that person or that thing isn't wrong. But at the same token, it's how you respond. So what I want to do is take the wisdom and the spiritual knowledge I have and help you out. You know, I don't want to see people oppressed, suppressed, depressed, stressed. I just don't want to see that. And you can't function. I don't care how great you are, how intelligent you are, honey. When you are going through it, you are not yourself. As a matter of fact, you somebody else. Hallelujah. Let's be real about that thing. And number three, I want you to know it's not the end of the world. God cares, and God will always send somebody that cares. I don't care what nobody say. God will always send somebody that cares. Because the main thing is, and I got to go here. I don't want to go here. You be thinking like family and friends going to be, man, those be the ones that don't understand sometimes. And I don't know why that's like that. Doesn't mean they bad people. Sometimes they add to it. In my wisdom and just walking in this life, you know, sometimes the best person to talk to is a stranger. Because guess what? You ain't gotta hide nothing. Oh, come on, somebody. Hallelujah. Y'all know it's the truth. Y'all know it's the truth because family gonna judge you, friends gonna judge you, and everybody. It behooves me how we all have the answer to others' problems except our own. I just say something. Y'all know it's true. I mean, we can. This is what you should do and how you should do it, and yet your life is kind of, y'all know. And so I want y'all to know no one is perfect. Everyone is hurting. Trying their best, but with God, it is possible to be and live with a peace of mind. I don't care what you have. I don't care who you have. If you don't have peace, my God, you going through it. One thing, and I live by this and I'm very serious. I don't let anyone or anything take my peace. If you even, I don't care who you are, listen to me. It could be family, friends, whomever. If anyone threatens my peace, I will cut you off so quick and make your head spin. And that is the same thing with anything that tries to come into my life and tries to disarray my peace. You guys got to start learning that. And people don't know that because we have become comfortable in being uncomfortable. Y'all know it's true. Come on, somebody. Hallelujah. So basically, and I want to talk about emotions. I want y'all to know enough is enough. You are not alone. Everybody goes through it. But you have to learn how to go through it. And you have to understand that every problem can be solved. I truly believe that that's what's wrong with people committing suicide. They get to the point where they don't believe that they can have a way out. You know, because I'm telling you, sometimes your mind is your own worst enemy. Oh, come on, somebody, don't play with me up in here. This is some real stuff. This is some true stuff. Sometimes we go through it to where we think it is the end. There is nothing we can do. No one can help us. And that's not true. Not with the God we serve. It'll feel like it. Oh, come on, somebody. We've all had those moments where it just feels like it is the end. There is nothing. You just want to give up. So this is going to be a very, this is going to be a different type class because I've never taught a class like this before. But I do it all the time with the prophetic and other classes, still living and healing, because that's what this is about. This is about peeling back that onion and find out what's really going on, because you'd be surprised. You're thinking it's this and it might be that. You're thinking it's him, it might be her. Oh, y'all ain't ready for me. We're going to peel that. We're going to peel it back. We're going to peel it back. The only requirement for this class is, are you ready to change? Are you ready for truth? Or I'm just being honest with you. So, like I said, just some things here. So let me go back to the first one. And we're going to have Q&A. That means people can actually talk. You know, I'm going to do it. GoToMeeting.com. It's not going to be on this Sunday. We're going to start next Sunday. Next Sunday at 3 o'clock p.m. God chose that because, like I said, I've never taught on Sundays. But he want you to start off the work week and your week with a positive affirmation. We're going to do affirmations. We're going to do vision boards. Whatever it takes to get you to the next level. Whatever it takes to get you out of being depressed, suppressed, stressed. Whatever it takes. And you better look at it like that. Whatever it takes. You don't let anything overtake you. Come on, somebody. Yeah, you're going to have your weak moments, but I'm telling you right now, you got to hang around people that are positive. You got to be with people that pour life into you. Come on, somebody. Stop being around people that drain you. Be around people that sustain you and love you. And hold on. When I say love you, I love you with your ugly self, because guess what? No one's perfect. But anytime somebody is constantly breaking your spirit, that's not God. You better get rid of them. Yeah, I said it like I said it. Hallelujah. Praise God, praise God. Oh, yes, King Pop, you can definitely join these classes. Yes, sir. So with that being said, go ahead to my website. You can go to the online store and you will find everything that you need to find. And that is it. The only requirement book I'm actually thinking is Pigs in the Parlor, because it's like a healing and deliverance. But I'll be actually, everything that I use are foundational based scripture. I don't ever just, you know, have my own co-curriculum. I just don't believe in that. I believe in Bible based biblical principles, because that's what God used to beat the devil with. And sometimes we want to write all these books, and I'm not saying we don't have knowledge, but if it don't come from God, our knowledge is nothing. Come on, somebody. Hallelujah. So I pray that you understand this class is going to be deep. People are going to be crying. I'm telling you, people are going to get healed. They're going to get whole, because notice what it says, spiritual wholeness. God is tired of his people being broken. He's tired of us breaking each other's spirit. Come on, somebody. It's okay to tell people the truth, but if you always breaking somebody's spirit, you need to look at you. You know what I'm saying? Those people that always got somebody, they always got something to say. But yet their life is jacked. Yeah, I say it how I say it. I'm just being real. We all go through. And therefore, we need to learn how to respect each other, how to love each other back to life. And if you don't have nothing good to say sometimes, just don't say nothing. Hallelujah. Y'all know it's true. Everything is not always negative. Come on, somebody. Hallelujah. We got to learn how to love people back to life again, for real, not for play. Hallelujah. And I want to say this before I get off of here. Even if you don't like someone, it's a way to do things. You don't have to be ugly. You don't have to be ugly, because you don't know if God may use you to help that person. You see, we're so busy talking about haters and enemies. Can I tell you something? We're all connected whether we like it or not. So my thing is, what are you really giving to people? What are you really ministering to people? Which spirit are they really seeing? Come on, somebody. Hallelujah. And I don't care what your gift is, what your calling is. Come on, somebody. If you have an ugly spirit, you have an ugly spirit. Hallelujah. So God bless you. God keep you. This is Apostle DEANNA DIXON. Roll out soldiers, for that is who we are. God bless. Hallelujah.